Did you solve it? What's the answer? Anybody got it? Anybody found the answer? Well, let's start with what the problem is asking, right? What does it ask? The initial concentration of B. How do you find the initial concentration of B? It gives you what? The rate constant? Does it? Yes. So you know the rate constant tells you the initial concentration of B, how much it is. What equation relates concentration with rate constant? That's the first thought. What is it? Huh? The Rayleigh law, right? That's the way you go. Every step you do should be reasonable. Why did you do that? Okay? So the Rayleigh law. Can you write the Rayleigh law down? What is the Rayleigh law in this case? Rayleigh law would be equal to rate constant times what? There is one but just B, so it's gonna be B. What? Y squared. Because what? You see, the problem doesn't tell you, but if you look at the units of the rate constant, then that means that you need to remember something too. Or you can figure it out. You can try one. You know when it's one, it's, you know, second minus one. You know when it's zero, it's molarity per second. When if it's two, you can just do it fast for just a few seconds, you can find out the second order. Okay, so from the units of the rate constant, you can find out the second order. There you go. So you have the rate law. Yes? So now, if I want to find out the initial concentration of B, then I have to know what? The initial rate of the reaction. Is that true? Yes. Now, I know the rate constant. So if I want to find this, I just need to find the initial rate. So the problem is finding out the initial rate. How much is the initial rate? Somebody said one. Correct. How many people want to explain to you why the rate is equal to one? Raise your hands. What is initial rate? You remember what we said is initial rate is? Initial rate is instantaneous rate. A time is equal to zero. Initial rate is a time is zero. That means it's instantaneous rate. An instantaneous rate is defined by the slope of the tangent at that time t for the curve. So a time initial rate, a time zero there, here is the curve, you find the tangent, and the slope of this angle will tell you the initial rate. What's the slope? What's the angle? 45 degrees. You see that? Yes, you can. And the slope is 1, isn't it? So the initial rate then from this graph, the initial rate is actually 1. Interesting? Interesting, huh? So from this, then, you can solve for B initial, and that will be what? If you put the values, you will find out that it's 2.
Professor, would you go down to this?
That's D. Yes? Up. Is that your problem? Oh, that's very true. You know? The teacher had a great time making it. Maybe it took him half an hour or maybe more to make it. But he was enjoying it. He was not doing it out of boredom or, you know, just feeling bad. He was just playing in his sandbox. Now, if you're smart, you can do the same thing. You take the exam and you solve these problems, or even if you don't solve them and you play in your sandbox. There are students that they do that. There are students that they do that. When they take the exams and they look at the problems, by solving them or not solving them, they're just playing in the sandbox. Find these students. They are next to you. They are in your dormitories. They are, don't say they were born like this, because you will never find the green pastures. Talk to them. Let them become your teachers. Tell them how you can be so peaceful and so content and be such a top student. Tell me, what did you do? And try to imitate them. Try to imitate them. And most of all, most important of all, try to do things for other people. If you just think for yourself, you will never make it right. Remember this. Right now, there's two people that are videotaping this seminar. One of them is your classmate, and another one is one of my older students. They are very beloved to me, because I can see they do things selflessly, and I put them in my heart. They came to videotape this for the people that they cannot come, or for you to see it one or two or three times if you want. They have discovered that by thinking about other people, they can be very happy. Without even doing anything, they are very happy. And then they have the strength to do the things that they need to be done. This is the true essence of education. Not writing the numbers down and get the correct ABCD. Don't forget that, because it will not go where you are trying to go. Did the musicians came? Yes. We're going to have a 10-minute break. You guys, you can relax if you want. It depends on you to allow yourself to relax. We're going to have some music. There's a couple of people here. They came to play music for you. And that's another example. These people coming to college did not allow themselves to forget their talent. You know, their parents spend money for them to know how to play music, right? And that there are students, they come, they have their instrument from high school, whatever. They put it there and they never touch it for 2 months, or a quarter, or 3 quarters, or probably their whole college years. They don't ever touch it. Why did your parents send you to learn music? So when you come to a position like this, that you can see most people go crazy, you can pick it up and play some music, and you purify your mind, and you get some strength. Otherwise, if you don't balance your lives, you will collapse a little bit. What are you going to play for us?
We're going to play a song called Waving Flag. Yeah, I love that. Bye.